take a step back. Cause it's a setback.
Not biggest name, yeah, okay, he's champion, he's undefeated, I'm going to UK and he has good record, yeah, everything is different. I think every step is bigger, biggest step, you know, like bigger and bigger and bigger, like step by step, and probably, hopefully this fight is a little bit bigger for me, because yeah, it's a very important fight with my unification fight with IBF. David Lemieux, and now, okay, not unification, is he's great boxer, he's new situation, I'm going to UK, I think every step is big. Look at me, I'm not big, you know, I'm still 160, everybody bigger than me in 160, you know. Right now my goal is all the belts in the middleweight division, because I stay in the middleweight division. And second question, yeah, of course I need big name. Okay, I go on 168, cool fight. You know, just everybody. Yeah, I respect all champions. It's great champions. It's not big star, you know, not big star, not big money fight. And it's not interesting, same like this. And okay, I go on to 154. No, not now, because I want just for Floyd. Just for Floyd.
With Floyd Mayweather, do you believe that would be the biggest challenge of your career if that were to transpire?
Absolutely. You know, just Floyd, he's a great champion, you know. And I understand that, you know, he's not big. He had a couple of fights in junior middleweight.
Yeah, he did.
Like, why not? You know, why not? And I understand he's a smart guy, he's a good fighter, respect his boxing style, you know, his business. He's a very good fighter. You know, just, I talk just, okay, I'm going to 154 just for Floyd. Just for Floyd, and I stay 160. And for me, it's not interesting, you know, like big names on 175, 168. Okay, like big name, of course I go. Right now, I never see, you know, who's a big star.
Maybe so, but you know what? You gotta give Floyd all the credit in the world. He's a genius. What he set out to do, he did it. He 49, is that how many he's got now?
Yeah,
49 have failed. 49 have talked a lot of smack and failed. We can do all the talking too, but when it comes down to fight time, if we sacrifice it down to 54 and I got a weak fighter and it's not strong enough to deal with his antics, It may be 50. Yeah. No, he's a genius, man. And again, you have to give him, whether you like him or dislike him, you have to give him credit for what he's done.
And do you feel that his defense is obviously the best that we've probably ever seen in the ring, dude?
I think
there's some guys out there.
Mistake his defense to talk like that. I think if you look back at when he was at 35 and even at 30, he was a great offensive fighter.
Yeah, got a few knockdowns.
Now that he's getting older, he's getting smarter. Now he doesn't fight as hard. He just hits you with the shots he wants to hit you with. That's why I say he's the genius. Because now that he's gotten older, he picks the shots that he wants to hit you with, and then he doesn't exert himself. He just does enough to win the fights. And we look at that as boring, some fans, but he's doing what he wants to do. He's not letting you hit him. And when you land an occasional shot, you don't hurt him anyway.
Yeah.
Shane got lucky, almost lucky, and hurt him. Yeah. But you know what? After that, he pissed a shot out. Yeah. So that's why I call him a genius, because as he's grown older, he's done enough to beat you and make you look silly and being defensive, but being offensive when he had to. But look back. Look back before when 35 and 30. He was a great offensive fighter.
No, I respect my fans because for me, it's not important. Yeah, of course, I come to the United States. You know, nobody doesn't know who I am. Everybody knows my style. You know, after first round, after first fight, everybody loved my style. I hope I'm going to regain. After this fight, everybody loved my style. Just respect my fans. Anyone?
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie.
Do you think it's going to be a hostile environment for him, or do you think the fans are going to enjoy him going for Triple G?
You know what? I think British boxing fans are very educated boxing fans. They appreciate talent. What showed me is that Gennady really has transcended the sport of boxing. Not one demographic, not one nationality. It's just everyone appreciates his style. It's when he fought Marco Antonio Rubio at the StubHub Center. He set the attendance record at the StubHub Center. So many great fighters have fought before at the StubHub Center. And Gennady actually set the record. And there is a large majority of Mexican boxing fans that were chanting for Triple G. So that showed me that he can transcend, really the nationalities. And I'm sure, Kell Brook's a very popular fighter in the UK. He's got his own very strong fan base that he's built up. He's another fighter that's not afraid. He fought Sean Porter in that arena at the StubHub Center, so he's not afraid to leave the UK and fight internationally. And he's going to have a lot of supporters, but we know Gennady is also going to have a lot of supporters, so we expect it to be a tremendous atmosphere in the arena. But I would say it's going to be a very evenly mixed fan base.
Thank you. Any more questions?
Question for Gennady. When you first came to America, nobody knew who you were. Now, as Tom mentioned, you transcended the sport. You've sold out arenas in Los Angeles, New York, now London. 4 years later, did you ever think you'd be this popular?
No, I respect my fans because it's, for me it's not important. Yeah, of course I come to the United States. You know, nobody doesn't know who I am. Everybody knows my style. You know, after first round, after first fight, everybody loved my style. I hope I'm going to be okay. After this fight, everybody loves my style. Just respect my fans.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak.